Next, I'm going to talk about the lateral hip pain. The leading cause of somatic pain with referred pain is greater trochanteric pain syndrome, and meralgia paresthetica is one of the common causes of neuropathic pain in the lateral hip. Greater trochanteric pain syndrome is characterized by chronic intermittent pain of the buttock and lateral aspect of the thigh. It may radiate down the leg to the level of iliotibial tract. The patients often feel pain when rising from the seated position, waking up for pain while lying on the affected side. A focal tenderness of the greater trochanter and iliotibial tract reproduces the patient's pain. But I believe it is a category of pain less than grade VAS 5. So most patients do not need the interventional procedure, so it is not a famous case in my pain clinic. Let's review more details about the greater trochanteric pain syndrome. There are various similarities between the shoulder and hip anatomy. There are three different bursae around the greater trochanter. Its location can differentiate these bursae. The subgluteus maximus bursa is the largest one in the greater trochanteric region. The greater trochanter is the facet providing muscle attachment of gluteus medius and minimus. Gluteus maximus and tensor fascia lata overlie the greater trochanter. The subgluteus minimus bursa is most anterior and placed between the greater trochanter and gluteus minimus tendon. The gluteus medius bursa is placed above the middle facet under the gluteus medius tendon. The subgluteus maximus bursa is placed between the greater trochanter and gluteus maximus and is often called the trochanteric bursa. The gluteus medius tendon pathologies may relate to trochanteric bursitis or lateral trochanteric pain. Therefore, you need to observe the bursal fluid or tendon pathologies nearby to find the pathology with the ultrasound scan. Let me show one case of trochanteric pain. It is the transverse scan along the greater trochanter. The white dot line is the bony cortex of greater trochanter, and the anterior facet provides attachment to the gluteus minimus. The lateral facet provides attachment to gluteus medius. Tensor fascia lata is superficially located, and gluteus medius tendon is interposed between the tensor fascia lata and bony cortex of a greater trochanter in a longitudinal scan. There is a low echo swelling of the tendinous portion of a gluteus medius on a longitudinal scan and high signal intensity of the same region on oblique coronal T2 weighted image, suggesting tendinosis. To relieve the pain of a greater trochanteric pain syndrome, we need to find the pathology first, then infiltrate the pathologic site and hydrodissect the trochanteric bursa with a low dose of steroids and dextrose solution. Meralgia paresthetica is a condition characterized by tingling, numbness, and burning pain in the outer thigh, and neuropathy of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is a leading cause. But spinal radicular pain mimic meralgia paresthetica, making decisions challenging. It is my clinical tip on how to tell the difference. If the patient complains of abnormal sensation or pain in the outer thigh, let the patient draw the border between normal to paresthetic area with a pencil. If the patient confidentially draw the border clearly, it is meralgia paresthetica. The patients can describe the border exactly like this illustration. That is why the cutaneous nerve is very discriminative and precise in localizing pain areas compared to the sensory nerve of the tendon and deep structures. If the patients could not describe the border and point ambiguously, it is spinal radiculopathy. If you have basic neuroanatomic knowledge, it is easy to understand. One spinal nerve root contributes to several peripheral nerves. Next, I'll talk about the detailed anatomy of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve and ultrasound features. I'll divide the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve into pelvic, inguinal, and thigh portions. The lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is placed in the interfacial space formed by fascia iliaca and fascia lata at the pelvic and inguinal portions. I'll skip the pelvic portion of lateral femoral cutaneous nerve because of limited lecture time. If you want more details, please visit my YouTube channel. Let's move on to the inguinal portion of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. Most of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve exits the pelvic cavity under the inguinal ligament. The inguinal ligament is a highly echogenic structure, so finding the nerve under the inguinal ligament is challenging unless it is pathologically swelled. Let's observe the exit point of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve in the inguinal canal. It may pass under the ligament close to ASIS or femoral triangle. A few lateral branches of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve may not pass under the inguinal ligament but cross over the iliac crest supralateral to the ASIS, 2.9%. Next is the thigh portion of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. This layer is the external abdominal oblique aponeurosis, inguinal ligament, and is continuous with the fascia lata. This layer is the superficial lamina of fascia iliaca. It's the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. The pelvic portion of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is positioned between the superficial and deep layer of the fascia iliaca. In the thigh, lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is placed between the fascia lata and deep layer of fascia iliaca. Let me show you one more. It is the cross section of the proximal portion of the thigh lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. These layers envelop it. The right side illustration shows the location of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve on the sartorius muscle and between the facial layers. This slice is the transverse sectional microscopic image of the proximal thigh. Let me zoom in. There are transverse sections of the multiple lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. It is the fascia lata. It is the fascia iliaca. The lateral femoral cutaneous nerve is located between the fascia lata and fascia iliaca until it penetrates the fascia lata. Some lateral femoral cutaneous nerve may divide into their terminal branches before crossing the inguinal ligament. Most lateral femoral cutaneous nerve divides into anterior and posterior branches after passing the inguinal ligament. The branching pattern of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve varied widely in the numbers of branches and the size of nerve fibers. Please observe the size of the nerves and neural vesicles to know the echotexture of the nerves. The small-sized neural bundles explain high echotexture. The lateral femoral cutaneous nerve looks echogenic structure surrounded by a neighboring hypoechoic fat layer and is less eye-catching. Things can be changed in several situations. The nerve could be prominent during hydrodissection. When it comes to pathologic swelling of the neural vesicles, it has become a prominent and hypoechoic structure. What do I do for interventional procedure? First, when there is a swell of the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, I try to decompress the compressive pathology. Next, however, I consider the pulsed radio frequency when I do not find any compressive features. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.